All right, made it over to the Flying Dutchman to pick up the water pump for the tractor. Well, there's no point in keeping the intro going because it is the tractor after all. Tony! The Flying Dutchman makes water pumps better than new. So, this is the unit off the tractor, and he told me not to do what the manual said to do. And that's because we went with the grease from the grease bowl bearings to the sealed bearings. Tony, what'd you do to my pump?
Put a real water pump seal in it instead of packing.
Okay. The packing went in this behind this brass nut here?
Yeah, behind this.
Now, wasn't there? It was just what? Two?
Nothing over there.
Two brass rings that went together.
Mm-hmm.
So the coolant would actually go past that until it got to the packing.
It got into the bushing. That's why you had to use special water grease to lubricate it.
They didn't say that in the manual. Special water grease. So, on this water pump, most water pumps have the bearings right inside the housing. This one, the pulley, rides on the bearing separate, kind of like a full floating axle, and the pump shaft rides through the inside and doesn't ride on any bearing at all. So all the load is taken by the housing without any being taken by the shaft, and this put together here. So how do we make it better than new? Well, like he said here on the packing, and he also put a seal in here. Now, did you have to machine this to put this seal in?
No.
You just measured the OD and...
Ordered one from Neely Bearing.
Okay. Well, you just measured the OD and the ID and got a bearing for it and...
A seal. I had the bearings in stock.
Seal for it and put it in there. Bearings in stock. Oh, that's nice. So we got sealed bearings in here, got a seal on the outside, because what this had was a felt washer in the back side of here, and then you just kept pumping grease into it until it started slinging it out the back side where the felt washer is. So we don't need a seal on the back side because we
yes,
got a seal.
Yes, we do.
Also, there's a seal on the back side too.
You know why?
Okay, I'm corrected.
You know why?
A little closer.
Dust.
Well, true. Lots of dust on the tractor.
Otherwise, the dust gets into the bearing.
So we've got a seal on both ends now where we had none before.
Yes, we did.
Well, not the rubber lip seals.
No. It was old style leather.
Leather or felt, neither one.
Yeah.
So we got two lip seals where there were felt before. We've got two sealed bearings where there were not sealed bearings before. It eliminated the need of having to put grease into here. And we have another lip seal. A third lip seal, so we don't have to have packing in behind this nut.
No, you don't have a lip seal in sight.
It's not. It's in here.
Right, there's not a lip seal in there.
I said there's the lip seal where now we don't have to have the packing here. Same thing. We're saying the same thing. So it's just the seal is in here now. He's going to take it apart. It's just that easy.
So now that is a real water pump.
Okay. So this is what he done. This used to have a brass bushing on the end of the shaft here, and another one down inside the housing. Did you have to machine this? Mm-hmm. So he machined this out. Oh, falling. To put this water pump seal in here. So if you have any worries about rebuilt water pumps, you can get them rebuilt better than new by going through the Flying Dutchman at fdrbp.com. I got it right that time. All right.
Okay, now while we're at it,
turn it up. Thank you, Tony. I'm going to be out cutting hay soon. Well, before we go putting it on there, one of the things I've got to do is make a gasket. I happen to have this leftover piece that nearly matches this thing perfectly. Three sides of it anyway. Now, if you've never made a gasket this way, you can do it if you have cast iron. Ball peen hammer. So right where the bolt hole is, use the ball end of your hammer. Just keep tapping it. Until it cuts that gasket material through. Like that. And then you gotta get the little piece out of there. Like that. Take one of your bolts. Do the next hole. Gasket custom fit. Well, I put it all in place. Now it's time for a little bit of rattle can red. And I don't much care about those hose clamps and that hose. Well, once it dries, then we'll put the belts on. Whoops! It's bent. Now I'm going to have to fix that first. Thank you.
Here's what it's looking like. Well, look at that, Biscuit!
You know who you are.
Where's my hat?
Oh. I gotta get my hat.
For those of you who don't know who Biscuit is, that would be Mr. Pisciotti, whose name sounds much like biscotti, which is an Italian biscuit. And he said it's more like a cookie. So I thought I'd start calling him Cookie. And then when I thought of that, I thought, if people are going to hear me calling him Cookie, bad impression. So I ain't calling him Cookie. Call him Biscuit. I never said it was a body, man. Where'd I put my paint? You know what? I'm supposing maybe I'll just paint the parts I can't get to once it's on the tractor. It's a very unique setup on this thing, as I explained earlier about how they have the shaft does not bear any of the weight of the fan or the tension of the pulley. So, that reminds me. I gotta put this awful nasty wore out belt because I forgot to go get another one for it. I put that on here. Before I do anything. Take care of that later. And the other belt. Oh yeah, that was tough getting out of there.
Your mission, Jim, should you decide to accept it, is to get this big old fat belt through that little skinny place there after you've put it on here. Let's see, which way does that rotate? It goes... that way, this goes that way, clockwise. So, you have to try to get this thing down here like this. And it gets itself wedged in there so tight you can't do anything with it. Get yourself a pushy tool. There it goes. Now, here's the interesting setup. Here's our water pump shaft. So this rides on its own bearing. It does not ride on the shaft. So when you want to tighten this belt, it's obviously loose. This is fixed and this is fixed, so how are you going to do it? Well, their solution to this problem is this part of the pulley and this part of the pulley are threaded. As you see, as I turn this, this gap widens, which means that it's moving that way. You'll see this castellation here, and what that is all about is there's a set screw that goes in here. Where are you at? There it is. There's four of these castellations, one every 90 degrees. So what you're going to do is you're going to line this up with one of those castellations, then you're going to put the set screw in it. After you get the proper tension of the bell. My paint's still sticky. I don't have time to wait for it to dry. And at no point did anybody ever say this was easy. Now the book says you want 3/4 of an inch deflection on this, but it doesn't tell you how much tension you need to be pushing against that belt with to get 3/4 of an inch deflection. All right, time for tools. That sticky paint don't help any. This particular belt has been loose since the day I bought the tractor 10 years ago. Time it ever had an overheating problem was when the radiator got plugged on it. It was all full of scale. Had to have take to the shop, radiator shop, have it boiled out. I'd say that's more than 3/4 of an inch. We're real close though. 3/4 of an inch, it's not going to be super tight when you're done. That's about 3/4 of an inch right there. Yeah, that's about right. I think I'll make it a little more snug. Snugger yet. And then what we have on the other side, this is where our set screw is going to line up. Come on, you. I like that. I think I'll put some never sees on that in order to facilitate my next adjustment. You don't have to yard down on it with an excessive amount of force. That's what that jam nut is for. That will prevent it backing out on its own. Now here's the other interesting setup on this thing. Oh, fan. We need our fan. These two pieces of hardware, threaded pins, I guess you would call them, for your springs. Whoop, where's the lock washers? There's got to be a pair of lock washers around here somewhere. I know where they went. Tony took them. He thought he could get away with taking mine so he could use them on something else. But I had another pair. Now these springs go on here, and I have no idea what this piece is called, other than a water pump shaft tension piece, if you want to call it that. There's a slot here in the shaft. This wedge is going to go in there through that hole. and see what that'll do is that puts spring tension out on that shaft. In the original design, before Tony made it better than new, there was two brass bushings in there. And those bushings would seal against one another. So this keeps a constant tension on those two bushings. But Tony changed that to a bearing and a seal, so it keeps a constant tension now on the bearing. And then the lip seal does its job. That's the way you make your water pumps last for years and years. Alright. Time for some more rattle can red. I know old Biscuit, he said, he didn't sand that or nothing. You're right, I didn't. That's why I use Rust-Oleum. Masking. I don't want red belts. They say to hold the can 8 to 10 inches away from the surface to be painted. I like the 2 to 3 inch method. Cuts down on the overspray. Gets more paint on your workpiece. Just gotta move a little faster. Nobody will ever know it wasn't a brand new tractor. What's next? Radiator? There's a bit more to these than your average truck radiator. Gotta line up both hoses at once. Body shop supply and get you some paint strainers. Keeps the moths out. And the flies and the mosquitoes. Moths, flies, and mosquitoes. Next! Well, it's the next day, there's no coolant leaks. The hay is ready. This thing's gotta get going. But of course, the dead battery.